नमस्कार दोस्तों, आपके हमारे YouTube चैनल ऑनलाइन स्टडी ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स में स्वागत है। पार्ट वन वीडियो में हम लोगों ने देखा कि चैप्टर रियल नंबर क्लास टेंथ का, जिसमें हम लोगों ने जाना यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा और यूक्लिड डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम के विषय में। उसका एप्लीकेशंस भी हम लोगों ने देखा कि किस तरह से हम यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा अप्लाई करते हैं। आज हम लोग रियल नंबर चैप्टर में जो एक्सरसाइज 1.1 है उसमें दिए हुए क्वेश्चंस का सलूशन देखेंगे। तो आइए आनंद उठाइए अपने उन सारे क्वेश्चंस का जो एक्सरसाइज नंबर 1.1 में दिए गए हैं। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज नंबर 1.1। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन है आपका, यूज यूक्लिड डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम टू फाइंड द एच सी एफ ऑफ 135 एंड 325। वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट हाउ टू फाइंड द एच सी एफ यूजिंग यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा इन पार्ट वन वीडियो। नाउ वंस अगेन वी वांट टू रिवाइज इट इन द पार्ट टू वीडियो, हाउ टू फाइंड द एच सी एफ यूजिंग यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा। सो डियर, हियर इज गिवन दैट 325 इज ग्रेटर देन 135, देयरफॉर लेट ए इक्वल टू 325 एंड बी इक्वल टू 135 यूजिंग यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा दैट इज ए प्लस बी क्यू इक्वल टू बी क्यू प्लस आर, वेयर R 0 is less than equal to R is less than B. Here A equal to 3Q and B equal to 135. So dear, 325 equal to 135 into 2 plus, because dear 135 into 2, that is 270, and 270 subtracted by 325, it will gives you 55. So dear, here R is not equal to 0, therefore again apply Euclid division lemma for A equal to 135 and B equal to 55, means 135 equal to 55 into 2 plus 55 into 2 means 110. 110 subtracted by 135, we will get how much? 25. So dear, again here R is not equal to 0. So we will apply once again Euclid division lemma, that is for A equal to 35 and B equal to 25. So it is 55 equal to 25 into 2, 25 into 2 that is 50, and 50 subtracted by 55 we will get only 5. Here R is not equal to 0 once again. Therefore, we will apply again Euclid division lemma for 25 and 5. So, it is 25 equal to 5 into 5. 5 into 5, that is 25 subtracted by 25, we will get 0. So, here R equal to 0. Hence, we get the final steps, that is HCF of 325 and 135 equal to 5.
So this 5 is final answer. This 5 is the HCF of the given two numbers 325 and 135. Now moving for question number second. Question number second is, show that any positive odd integer is of the form of 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5, where q is some integer. Then how can we solve? By using Euclid division lemma. Here our result is required 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3, 6q plus 5 and a positive integer, positive odd integer. So let us consider, let x be a positive integer and b equal to 6. Why? Because our requirement is 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 and 6q plus 5. So we will take b equal to 6. Then by Euclid division lemma, that is a equal to bq plus r, where 0 is less than r less than b, and here a is x, we have to take in it is x, so a equal to, therefore a equal to x, and b is taken as 6, 6q plus r, and 0 is less than r less than 6, because we have to take b equal to 6. This implies that is the value of r is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because r is lies between 0 and less than 6. 0 and less than 6 means the value of r is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we substitute these values in this equation number 1, 1 by 1. When r equal to 0, then x equal to 6q plus 0. This implies that 6q for r equal to 0. R equal to 1, then x equal to 6q plus 1. You substitute the value of r in this equation, that is x equal to 6q plus 1 for r equal to 1, because the value of r is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This implies that x equal to 6q plus 1. For r equal to 2, then x equal to 6q plus 2. This is same, 6q plus 2. After that, when you put r equal to 3, then x equal to 6q plus 3. This implies that same value, 6q plus 3. Now for r equal to 4, then x equal to 6q plus 4. Implies that same value, 6q plus 4. And last value here is given r equal to 5. So you substitute r equal to 5, then x equal to 6q plus 5. You will substitute this value in this equation. This is Euclid division lemma, and we have to take an positive odd integers as x, and the value of r is 6. Therefore we substitute the value of r 1 by 1 in this equation. We have the same value, 6q plus 5. Now dear, you observe all these value. This is even and this is also even, and 6q plus 4 is also even. Therefore here 6q plus 2, 6q plus 4 are even values. Even. And 6q plus 1 and 6q plus 3 and 6q plus 5 are odd. Therefore, we have a result that every positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1 or 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. So this is the final result for this. 6q, 6q plus 2, 6q plus 4. When we put any value of q, then always we will get the even number after simplification. And in this expression, when we put any value of q, then we will get the odd integer. Therefore, for any positive integer, the odd integer will be in the form of 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. Now moving for next question number 3. Question number 3, here is given a statement that any army contingent of 616 members is to march behind an army band of 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of columns. What is the maximum number of columns in which they can march? So dear, here total number of students are given 616 and 32 members are in each parade. And maximum number of columns required for this. So dear, we will write here total number of members are 616 and member in each parade is equal to 32. Therefore, maximum number of columns is required. So we will find how, dear. We will use here Euclid division lemma by Euclid division lemma. We have A equal to BQ plus R, where 0 is less than R is less than B. So dear, we have to take here A equal to 616 and B equal to 32. That is 616 is greater than 32. Therefore, using above lemma, we get 616 equal to 32 into 19. 32 into 19, how much dear? 608. And 608 is subtracted by 616, we will get 8. Therefore, here R is not equal to 0. Again apply Euclid division lemma for 32 and 8. Therefore, it is written as 32 equal to 8 into 8 4 is 32. There, 32 minus 32 will gives you 0. Here R equal to 0. Therefore, This process is end. Now the HCF of 616 and 32 is this 8. Therefore, maximum number of columns are, therefore, maximum number of columns equal to 8. This is the final answer of this question. So we will apply here Euclid division lemma, then we get the final answer. This is it. Now moving for next question number 4. And question number 4 is given here. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 for some integer m. तो इस क्वेश्चन में भी हमें यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा यूज करना है. तो यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा के लिए हमें जो फॉर्म दिया है दैट इज 3m एंड 3m प्लस 1. सो हाउ कैन बी अप्लाई एंड प्रूव दिस. सो क्वेश्चन इज यूज यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा टू शो दैट द स्क्वायर ऑफ एनी पॉजिटिव इंटीजर. सो स्क्वायर ऑफ एनी पॉजिटिव, नोट दिस पॉइंट. सो बी let any positive integer be x and be equal to, here we will take 3. 3 is requirement, so we will take here 3. Therefore, by Euclid division lemma, by Euclid division lemma, that is A equal to BQ plus R, where 0 is less than R less than B, and A we have to take in as X and R B is 3. Therefore, this is X equal to 3Q plus R, where 0 is less than equal to R less than 3. Therefore, R is defined for 0, 1 and 2, because the condition of R is 0 is less than equal to and less than 3. Less than 3 means it is 2 and 0 is included here. So the value of R is 0, 1, 2. Then how can we solve? Now, putting all these values of R in this equation number 1. From equation 1, we get 1 by 1 when R equal to 0, then X equal to 3Q plus 0. This implies that only 3Q. But question says that square of any positive, on squaring both sides, on squaring both sides, we get, there this is X square equal to 3Q whole square, that is 9Q square, is written as 3 into 3Q square, that is 3M, because M is any integer. Sure dear, because M is the any integer. When we take the any value of Q, then we have a single value of this expression. Let us, it is M. So the X square equal to 3M. Again, you take R equal to 1. When R equal to 1, then X equal to 3Q plus 1. You substitute the value in this equation, that is 3Q plus 1. on squaring both side, on squaring both sides, we get that is x square equal to 3q plus 1 whole square using identity, that is a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus v square. Using this identity we get here 3q whole square plus 2 into 3q into 1 plus 1 square means it is 9q square plus 6q plus 1. So dear, this is 9q square plus 6q plus 1. Using this identity, after we take this expression as in the form 3 is taken as common, then this is 3q square plus 2q and plus 1. This is 3 and let us consider this is the value of m. When we simplify for the any value of q, we will get a single value. Let us this is m and plus 1. Where you can write it 3q square plus 2q equal to m. Okay, after that for the next value r equal to 2, when r equal to 2, then from the equation number 1, this is x equal to 3q plus 2 on squaring both sides. We get, dear, this is x square equal to, using once again this identity, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square, we will get a square, that is 3q whole square plus 2ab, that is 3q into 2, plus b square, that is 2 whole square. So dear, we will write it as 9q square plus 2, 2 ja 4, 3 ja 12q plus 8. Okay dear, now this is written as 3 is common in this. Then we get by taking 3 as common and 2 square means 4. 2 square means 4. So dear, we will write this expression as 9q square plus 12q plus 3 plus 1. 4 is written as 3 plus 1. Now taking 3 is common in these 3 terms, then we get 3q square plus 6q plus 1. When we take 3 is common from here, then 1 is remainder. Sorry, plus 1. So this is 3, and let us consider the value of this expression be m. So this is m. Therefore we can observe that here the square of any integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 and again 3m plus 1. So we will write here final result. Therefore any positive integer in square form are 3m, 3m plus 1. Only these two, 3m and 3m plus 1. So this is the answer of this question. Thank you dear, we will meet again in the video part 3 for the exercise number 1.2. थैंक यू सो मच.